everyone. Welcome to Jitendra's Biology.
You take what are na? Tannins. Tannins are what? Actually, they are carbon compounds. They are what are na? Carbon compounds. And they are what in color? Brown in color. They are which color na? Brown in color. And what is the use of these tannins? The tannins are useful for in this only meaning. That is tanning of leather. Tanning of what? Leather in leather industry. What about tanning means? The raw leather becomes very soft. So the leather which is the skin which is collected by the animals will send into the leather industries. In the leather industries, the rough skin will make it very smooth with help of what? Tannins only. Okay, by that smoothening only rough skin, then they'll be made up of this your belts, purses, handbags and luggage, okay, bags and etc. So in that is useful. Not only they are useful in the tanning of leather, they are also useful in the preparation of certain medicines. And where we can get these tannins? Tannins are getting from a plant called acacia and cassia. Acacia and what? Cassia. So acacia means nothing but, you know, tangedu chettu. In Batakamma time they'll use yellow color flowers will be. Okay. Cassia means tumma chettu. Small spines will be present. Chinna chinna mullu untayi nana. Okay. Tumma chettu. That is acacia and cassia. And the second one what he given, that is resins. What is that na? Resins. You take resins. These resins are present in the gymnosperm plants. They are present in what na? Gymnosperm plants. Okay. Where they are present? They are present in the resin passages. They are present in what na? Resin passages. Okay. And these resins are useful. Okay. To produce for preparation of what na? Varnishes. Preparation of what? Varnishes. That is nothing but before painting. Okay. Before the painting. That is in new wooden furnitures. This black oil will be get painted. That is called varnish. That is producing from this resins only. Actually, this resins example plant for this resin is nothing but pinus plant. What is that? Pinus plant. How the pinus plant means? Especially in the cold area, they will be grow. Okay. That is just like a Christmas tree. Okay. They will be just like what? Christmas tree. And you take next one is called gums. You take gums. These gums are actually produced by the plants called as acacia. And moreover, whenever the plants gets wounded at that time, what will happen? To seal that wounds, and these plants will produce a sticky substance. That sticky substance which is producing, okay, that will be gets absorbed water. They absorb the water, and they become more sticky. And then what will happen? They become binded. This water and sticky substance will get binded each other, and they form what na? Gums. And these gums are useful in what na? Acting as adhesives. Acting as what? Adhesives and binding agent. Adhesives and what na? Binding agents. In which industries? It are useful in the what? Paper industry as well as in the food industries. You know that different types of food will have the colors. How, what that colors are they getting? They are nothing but with the help of this gums itself. Okay. Of course, that gum will be collected from the plants and they'll send into the industries for refining. And after refining, they are adding into that food industry to get the attractive colors for the foods to get it. Okay. This is about the gums, Nana. X is milky white substance, Nana. Milky white. Okay. At the same time, sticky in nature. Milky white, sticky. Okay, substance. Milky white, sticky substance. They are producing from a plant called a rubber plant. What is that, Nana? Rubber plant. This rubber plant scientific name is Hevea brasiliensis. Okay, and a rubber plant. From this latex is collected and it is useful in the production of rubber. They are useful in the production of what? Rubbers. Rubber means with help of rubbers we will make our tubes. Okay. As well as tiles. Okay. Tubes, tiles. Okay. Etc. can be prepared by this latex. Nana. And next you take that is a jatropha plant. Jatropha plant. From the jatropha plant seeds, we can produce what? Biodiesel. We can produce what? Biodiesel. That is also in a latex. From the latex of the seeds. From the latex of the jatropha seeds only, we can produce a biodiesel. So this is about that. Next you take chisel nana. What mean by this chisel? Chisel means that is a natural latex. It is a natural latex which is useful as a chewing gum. Is it useful as what nana? Chewing gum. This has been known from 5000 BC onwards. From that we feel that chewing gum is a modern product. No, it is not a modern product. 5000 BC only this chewing gum has been produced from the natural latex, that is called what? Chisel. Actually from which natural latex means? The plants like sapota. Okay, plants like sapota, they will be this natural latex of sapota useful in preparation of what nana? Chisel. Okay. And next, this along with this, another one more concept you have to learn, that is called Brueggemann. What is that, Anna? Brueggemann. He is one of the scientists, Brueggemann. He told plants always not only absorb the liquids and fluids, water, minerals from the soil, but also they secrete certain materials into the soil. Okay, that is plants secretes. Plants secrete certain substances. Okay, what type of substances they secrete, Anna? Chemical substances. They secrete what? Chemical substances into the soil. They secrete what? Chemical substances into what? Soil. And these chemical substances will also sometimes they will be polluting the water, na? Soil. And they would happen, the yield, that is the fertility of the soil will get decreased. This he found out in an apple crop. A person is growing apple crop in 4 to 5 years in the same piece of land. That apple plant roots are secreting certain chemicals. Due to the releasing of that chemicals, what happened? Year after year, first year good yield got, second year somewhat less, third year still less. So what is the reason behind that? He did experiment, means he come to know that certain chemicals which has been secreted by this apple plant roots, that chemicals are getting the, that is fertility of the soil getting less. That is the reason the yield of the apple crop has been got decreased. Okay, so this is about the Brueggemann's investigations. Next, you take now excretion, okay, versus secretions. Excretion versus what, nana? Secretion. Actually, both are same, nana. Excretion, secretions are same. Both are the process which are useful for the movement of substances. They are useful for what, nana? Movement of substances in living organisms to send out. To send what, nana? Out. But little bit difference is there. What is that name? You take excretion is a passive process. It is what is passive. Passive means what? It is a very slow process. But whereas secretion, it is an active process. Active process means what? It is a very fast process. And in the excretion, what will happen? The movement of molecules. The movement of what? Molecules will occur from the body to outside. From the body to what? Outside. Whereas in the secretion, same the movement of molecules will occurs, okay, moments of molecules will occurs from where? From the body to either outside, just like Brueggemann just now I said, or else within the body also, or else what, na? Within the body also, they can move from one place to what? Another place, that is also called secretion. And example for excretions are nothing but you take tears, okay, sweat, okay, urine, etc. and fecal matter, okay, fecal matter, etc. all comes under what? Excretory products. They comes under what? Excretory products. Whereas the secretory products are what? The secretory products are nothing but just now we discussed, now tannins, okay, resins, okay, latex, gums, okay, as well as alkaloids, etc. This all comes under what, na? That is the secretory products. And in this, of course, excretory products, that is gasoline, carbon dioxide also there, and even water also, excess water also there. Okay, so these are the excretory products, these are the secretory products. In human beings, you take secretory products are nothing but what, nana? Enzymes, okay, as well as that is hormones, enzymes, hormones, etc. will come under what? That is secretory products. This is about the excretion versus secretion. And last we have annexary also. What is that? In annexary we know about the organ donation. That is one of the important topic, nana. Organ donation. Okay. Before going to know about organ donation, we have to know importance of organ donation. If any person is at brain dead, if he donates his organs, and the person who is in the need of that organs, they will get their life. So that's why organ donation is a very good okay, process and try to bring the awareness among the people about the organ donation. Okay, and which type of organs can be donated means we can donate eyes, we can donate liver, we can donate the heart, we can donate the intestines. Okay, we can donate what? Intestines. And we can donate that is the bones. Okay, we can donate the skin, we can donate the blood. These are the various organs which can be donated in our body. Of course, in heart, four valves are there. One valve, one fellow also we can donate. So like that, different a person can give the life even after his death also with help of organ donation. And that Jeevan Daan organization is one of the good organization in our India. It is running all over our India and they are collecting the organs from the brain dead patients and they are giving to the persons who are in the need. And this organ donation transplantation can be occurred in approved hospitals, in some of the corporate hospitals which are approved by the government, and of course in the NIMS as well as Usmania hospitals like a government hospital also it is taking place. At the district headquarters also some hospitals are given this permission to get transplantation of organ donations. And the transferring of organs from the brain dead persons to the needy person is called as cadaver transplantation. That is called what? Anna? Cadaver transplantations. That is called what? Cadaver transplantations. Okay, that you have to remember this word. The transferring of organs from a brain dead person to the needy person is called what? Cadaver transplantation.